Hi there. The spooky season is here, and sadly, there aren't many jams this month. However, I've still compiled some of the best upcoming jams for the month, so let's not waste any more time and get straight into it. Starting earlier today and lasting for a week, this jam asks you not to create a game, but instead, a Discord bot. Whilst not being about games, it can help you to improve your skills at integrating with external APIs, which is an important skill for programmers. Cosmic Horrors, a subgenre of horror that emphasises themes of cosmic dread, madness, fate and many others. That's what this jam focuses on. Running from the 13th to the 27th, you need to create a game that is part of the Cosmic Horrors genre. Starting on the 14th and running for 11 days, Project Revival Jam wants you to take an old project and finish it. It's the perfect time to finally finish that game you gave up on, and maybe even give it a fresh coat of paint. It's time to bring that old dead project back to life. Mashup Games are hosting their third annual Game Jam, and it's a good opportunity to get started in Game Jams, as they're a smaller community that can allow you to get a good start into making games. The jam is running from the 14th till the 24th, enough time for a decent sized project. Time to dust off those nostalgia glasses, because the 32-bit jam starts on the 17th and ends on the 31st. You need to make a game that looks like it could be from the PS1 era. There's even an additional rule that allows for homebrew entries for those crazy people that need an extra challenge. It's October, so I had to include at least one game that celebrates the season. And the spooky 2D jam is exactly what I needed. Running from the 21st to the 23rd, you need to create a spooky game with only two dimensions. The title says it all. Since consoles took over from arcades, high school games have become less common. Well, the School Space Jam is a 3-day jam starting on the 21st that has a rule requiring the game to include a leaderboard. Time to compete for the best high score game. And that's the list. If you think I've missed an important jam, let me know in the comments section down below. Thank you for watching, and a special thank you to Vimluck for letting me take over this series. I'll see you all in the next one.